Hello, Santaquin Steak Saints. I'm excited to be here with you today. I am Sister Brianna Hess, and I am currently serving as the stake primary president. We recently were able to have a stake primary activity, a missionary activity, where we had the 10 and 11 year olds come and participate. And there are just a few wonderful things that happen, a few miracles and things that happen in the planning and going through that activity that I get to share with you today, and I'm excited about that. So for our activity, we chose to do a missionary invitation. And with that, we invited each of the children to come using a missionary call. And I was really impressed by that. The feedback that we received was that it was an important moment for families. And as they read that and they heard their child's name called, they were able to imagine in their mind what that moment might feel like. And it was just a really spiritual experience for people. And we were so grateful for that, even just in the invitation. Another thing that was really important to us was to use the youth and primary theme. So even though it was a missionary activity, we still wanted to use social, physical, spiritual and intellectual in our activity. And so we did that. And each one of the activities had to do with one of those themes, but also it tied in with missionary work. So for example, for physical, we did food because missionaries need to know how to feed themselves. But we also talked about things that we can do that keep us physically healthy, and that was just a fun thing, and they were able to make their own treat that way, which was really good for us as well. So that was fun. So our next group was the spiritual group, and we had two people do this one. It was Sister Marchin and Brother Robbins, and they did an excellent job talking about preparing to go to the temple and what we might need to do. And it was really important for us to not only create an opportunity for the kids to feel the Spirit, but also to help them realize when they were feeling the Spirit. So Sister Marchant talked with them a lot about different ways that we feel the Spirit, because we know that not a single one of us will feel it the same way. And so she talked to them about different ways that they might feel it and different places that they might feel it. And I was in there with them just for one of their sessions, and she talked about feeling it as she was hiking. And she got to a place where it was really hard, and she remembered a story of her friend where she looked for rocks shaped as a heart, and that's how she knew Heavenly Father loved her. And when this moment was really hard for Sister Marchant, she looked down and she saw a rock shaped like a heart, and she knew Heavenly Father loved her and that she could do this hike. And so that was a really special moment for her, and she was able to tell the kids of different places that you can feel the Spirit and just help them learn to recognize for themselves, because that's an important aspect of their life, to know that the Spirit's talking to them and to know that it can come in lots of different ways. And Brother Robbins talked to them about temple preparation, and we wanted to go over the questions with them and just let them know they're not secret, and that they can prepare by using those questions right now. And then they were able to make a picture to put in their room of those questions so that they can always have them. The next group we did was for intellectual. And we talked about preparing financially to be able to serve a mission and saving. So I called in an expert, a stake expert, Sister Lindsay Johnson, for this one. She's done the stake financial class. And so she did this class for them. And she showed them a video of a young man who worked for years just to save $275 to go and get a passport so he could serve his mission. And we talked about sacrifice and just important things that we can put aside to be able to be ready to do the Lord's work. And so Sister Johnson showed him that video, and then she had them make a little money bank, a missionary money bank that they could use to save some money now for their mission. Finally, we did this social group, and this one was fun. We had a few different ideas for this one, and I had asked one of my counselors to take care of it, and so she went to prepare the activity, and as she was standing preparing an activity in a lady's home, she had a vision come to her mind of a different activity and a moment in her life that was very difficult, and something that came and comforted her at that moment, and so she changed the activity. So when she arrived, she had a different activity than what we had planned, and I was a little caught off guard, and I was like, why are we doing this? What happened to our other activity? And she was like, you know what? I had this vision. I think this is what we're gonna do. And so that's what we did. And so For that activity, they tied quilts. And for the quilt activity, I said, what are you gonna do with these quilts? And she's like, I don't know, maybe someone in our state needs them or we'll donate them to a local hospital. And I thought, you better find a hospital because nobody in our state will need these quilts. I don't know what we're gonna do with these quilts. And so the children tied the quilts and they learned about serving others and really just keeping their baptismal covenant to mourn with those who mourn and comfort those who stand in need of comfort and to just look after Heavenly Father's children. And that was important for us to recognize that that's a covenant that they've already made. And so the quilts were tied and Sister Jensen took them back to her house and prepared to take them to a hospital somewhere. And a few days later, we received a phone call that a father in our stake had died. And immediately we knew that that's what we wanted to do with those quilts. And so we took them over and were able to give them to those children and write them a special note. And a few weeks later, the same thing happened in another ward, and the rest of those quilts will be taken to that family. But I knew, and Sister Jensen knew especially, that Heavenly Father had sent that vision to her mind, and that it was a way that we could serve those families in a desperate time of need. And so we were really grateful for that. So this activity was a great opportunity for us to review with those children the covenants that they've made and the opportunities that they have to feel the Spirit, and hopefully to help them recognize when the Spirit's talking to them. And that was our main goal in doing this, and we feel like that we were able to accomplish that, and we're just so happy to be with them. We know that it was such a good experience for them, and just so much love felt and so much of the Holy Ghost felt there, and we're just grateful for any time that we can do that with these children. We're just so grateful to serve with these children, and we're humbled at the gifts of the Spirit that we received as we planned this activity and carried it out. And we know that these children are going to be prepared to serve missions in their life and to bless Heavenly Father's children by using these principles that they were taught.